So I just got done talking to my husband about all of these things. Because clearly he's worried about me, which makes total sense. And I appreciate him so much for walking through these things with me, because these are very new emotions, very new realizations in the perspective that I'm at now. Because the fact of the matter is I don't want to be afraid of people. I don't want to be afraid of intimacy. I don't want to be afraid of making a mistake. I want to be able to make a mistake, make an error, and realize that, hey, Meredith, in 5 minutes, it's going to be over. It's not the end of the world. You're going to survive this. It's not that big of a deal. And the reason I'm talking about this on here is because I promise you that there are many people out there who fear people, fear intimacy, fear getting close, hate themselves when they make mistakes, and at times can't see the light at the end of the tunnel. And that's why I'm talking about this. Because maybe when you were a kid, when you would make a mistake, it would be the end all be all of horrible. Your value was placed in being perfect or not making mistakes. And if you did make a mistake, it would go badly. When my kids tell me that they don't have clean socks for school, or that the dinner tasted bad, or that I screwed up the schedule for their sports, it's like bullets to me. I have failed, profoundly failed. And because they have brought this to my attention, they are the reason for my feelings of failure, which completely freaks me out, like to the point where I'm literally shaking right now, because I don't want to feel like that. I want it to be, there's no socks, the dinner didn't taste good, you screwed up the schedule, and that's okay. I want to feel like it's not the end of the world. I want to feel like it's going to be okay in 5 minutes. And that is why I am dissecting this and looking at it and going, you are not 9 years old anymore. You are safe. You are not 9 years old. You're not going to get in huge trouble. You're not going to be yelled or screamed at or whatever. It's okay. You're an adult now. And I promise there are a lot of people on this app that feel this way. And that's why I'm sharing, because you're going to be okay too. I don't love bomb in a relationship because I'm trying to garner affection. I do that because I want things to be good. I don't hold back my feelings and my things because I'm trying to be evasive or be a martyr. I do that because I am afraid of intimacy and that it will be used against me somehow, or that I will be seen as weak, which gives the other person an upper hand. And I also don't want to take up space in their life, because I don't feel worthy of taking up that space.